It has been a soggy morning down along the Mississippi and Louisiana coastline. Lots of rainfall with the stalled boundary keeping the majority of that moisture south of central Mississippi. Still dealing with rain this morning. A lot of that heavier downpour activity has been tailored north of I-20 from Pickens to Yazoo County and into the southern part of Sharkey County. Down to the south, hit and miss light showers. But this is really what I think is going to happen today. We'll have the rainfall. Everyone is expected to see rain at some point today. But we're going to get breaks in the rain throughout. So do not expect a complete washout of a forecast. 75 degrees right now around 7 o'clock in Jackson. Much of central Mississippi have been tailored to the mid-70s. And really highs today are only going to go up about 5 to 7 degrees. So many of us stay in the 70s, if not hover right around 80 to 82 later this afternoon. It's all thanks to the wet forecast and the cloud cover to keep us on the cooler side today. Again, by this afternoon, I do still expect some breaks in the rain. Could we get heavy rain at times? Yes, I think that's a possibility. But overall, when it comes to heavy training showers, I'm not really buying it just as much today. Tomorrow, we may get a couple of places, but even then, it's going to be a steady rainfall, not expecting thunderstorms. The coverage may be a little bit better tomorrow if we can get that stalled boundary to break down and that low pressure to move east. If it stays how it is today, tomorrow's rainfall will be just like today, on and off, scattered across the area, heavy at times. Flash flooding, not a major concern at this time. It's very conditional, really. If we get any flood threats, that's honestly going to be tailored down towards the coastline in South Louisiana. If we see any across central Mississippi, it's going to be south of the metro where the heaviest of the rainfall totals could accumulate 2 to 4 inches. But one thing in the metro, if we have to watch for any threat for flash flooding, will be how long it takes to get us to 1 to maybe 3, if we're lucky, inches of rain. I think it's going to be more of a steady rainfall, meaning those rainfall totals go up over the next 24 to 36 hours, not all in a matter of an hour or two. So that's why I'm not really thinking a big flash flood threat for the next 24 to 36 hours. We'll watch it, see how the modifications react, but it's just not looking very likely at this point. Upper 60s, low 70s tomorrow morning. Just like today, we're looking at a struggle with the temperatures, 70s to around mid 80s. Off to the Delta, Blitz 16, game of the week, Brandon versus Madison Central. Here's the good news. The rain looks to dry out heading into the evening. Pretty much overcast, though, for the nighttime, and temperatures stay in the 70s. The downside with Blitz 16 is the fact that the ground is going to be wet. We'll dry out as we head into the weekend. Breezy to start off Saturday. Temperatures quite cool Sunday and Monday morning, but we'll get back to the mid to upper 80s for the first half of next week.
Oh, my God.